Hot Potatoes. So today I am back with my hauls. I know it's been a million years since I last made these hauls. Everything in this collective haul is just like stuff that I've gotten in since January, months, okay? So don't judge me on the number that you see in the title. Actually, go ahead and judge me for my poor life choices. My mom does it all the time. I think my biggest regret is not filming these hauls in parts, like just throughout the progression of this year, because you can see kind of my style evolving a bit. I gained quite a lot of weight, and it's all, you know, I have a food baby on the way every day. I'm already sweating because I'm so excited, or it's just getting really hot in my room. Either way, I'm glad you guys can't smell me. If you live for my hauls, click that like button and let me know that you do. So everything in this video is from Misguided, and nothing was sponsored. I bought everything with my own money because I don't have a sugar daddy. So first I'm going to be showing you what I got from the Peace and Love brand. It is higher quality stuff, so it's more expensive. So pretty much for all the Peace and Love items, I got it in the size US 2. And I got a lot of compliments on this outfit when I wore it out. It is this beautiful romper. It looks like a dress from the front, but it's actually a romper, and you can see it clearly from the back. Oh my god, and I already got a stain on it. The neck closure are those little pirate hooks. What are they called? Argy hooks. So this is not a set. I had to buy these separately. I think I should have gone with a size 4 for this. I feel like then it would give me more room for my food baby. But the only thing is the top that comes with it, it doesn't even come with it. It's trying to charge you extra, you know what I'm saying? For what? For what? My thought process was, if I got a US 4, I'm gonna get more material and it's gonna hide my boobies more. Nope, not the case. You still get basically a thong of a top. Like, my small boobs are still too big for what's going on here. Like, what is this gonna cover, a nipple? Like, I am just having a moment with red. I've been loving red lipsticks and red clothing and just little pops of red here and there. This I wore in my upcoming lookbook. It's such a high quality dress. It's actually quite thick, so it's perfect for the holidays if you are having those holiday parties indoors. I love that bodysuits are a thing. Look at these bold shoulder pads. The fabric is so nice. It feels really smooth. And it's button closure, so you don't have to take off the whole thing. I think bodysuits are just like pointless if you don't have a button closure. Like, if it doesn't have a button clasp, I'm just gonna be like, that's a no for me, dog. I'm gonna pass. You guys have already seen these in my lookbook. The beautiful, I just said it like how my dad says, beautiful girl, what you doing? I'm 5'4½ and I have to wear like my 5½-inch heels with these. Yeah, they make me look super tall. I mean, it sucked ironing these, but they're so beautiful. When I wear this, I feel like super serious, and I'm just like channeling Gossip Girl Blair vibes. I love the gold buttons. There's actually a detailing to it. There's a little shoulder pad right here. I like wearing this with like a simple dress and then throwing this on top to tie the whole outfit together. I think it's perfect fall wear and also good for going out and all that, you know. So I got a size 2, and honestly I should have gotten a size 0 because this is actually quite loose for a bandage dress. Love this deep plunging neckline. It comes in black also, and the back has this nice low scoop back. And it is just very classic and chic. Next, I got something that I'm not sure if I love. So I was just thinking of throwing it up on the Poshmark. I think it's still cute. I just don't know if I'll ever wear it. So crisscross back, adjustable straps. I was thinking of wearing like a thin sweater top underneath this just to kind of tie it together in a little belt. The dramatic neckline really gets me. I'm just like, damn girl. It's kind of like businessy but fun, and yeah, it's doing that. It is doing that. Another pink item is this dress, but I feel like a dress like this definitely needs some kind of boning underneath, because when you're walking around it starts to wrinkle up like right here, and it's not a cute look. So now I'm going to move on to the misguided items. I got this crop top. I actually already showcased it in my lookbook, but it was really cheap. I like that it looks like it's already knotted here, and I like, that it's a crop top so I can wear all my high-waisted stuff with it. I never really liked navy, but navy, like red, is growing on me. But I like that it's this beautiful navy blue color, and I do get a lot of compliments when I wear this. I love this. It's so simple, and I like pairing it with a very dainty necklace, a blazer jacket over top, or like a jean jacket to like kind of dress it down or something. It's just so versatile. I absolutely adore this dress. I wore this to a friend's loft party, and also the same night I wore it to a birthday dinner. It's very versatile. It's just so elegant, and I love the champagne color. The zipper is in the back. It's also like a low drop back. I have another satin dress. Ooh, surprise. This one is a white. I think it's like super bridal for like if you go to like a bachelorette party and the bride would be wearing this. Here, I wore it to a friend's dinner, and I just love how simple it is. You could dress it up with like a fancy belt or just like dress it down with like a jean jacket. This dress had a strope, okay? So this side is like very drapey. It's asymmetrical. That's the style. And then I wore this out one time. I think it was Drop It Like It's Hot came on. In my head, the thought process was like, no, you shouldn't, because it's already tight around your hips. You're definitely gonna rip the dress. And the other side's like, no, you gotta drop it like it's hot. So I dropped it like it's hot and ripped the side of the dress. So I haven't fixed it yet, so I haven't been able to wear it. Let me just show you proof of my fail. This dress is just a cute girls' night out kind of dress, or like a dinner date or something like that. If you don't like something that's deep plunging, just throw on a bralette. No. But this is a very deep plunging neckline dress. You have to wear a gel adhesive bra with it. But I love the color. I love how sleek it looks, and it looks stunning on. This I wore in my upcoming lookbook. I love this. I got so many compliments wearing this. I wore this with a black scallop, like bodycon tight dress for dinner, and this on top, and it just pulls the whole outfit together. It looks so good, and I love the asymmetry of the cut underneath. Like if you have wider hips like I do, I would go up a size, because I feel like when I do wear it as a blazer dress, it can kind of be like a little like tight, so it's like a little fold right here. Moving onward here, we've got this blouse, ruffled, beautiful, beautiful. I just wanted to say it with that face. I think it's just so adorable, and I love how girly it is, and I like the silky material, so. I haven't worn this yet. It is definitely like thinner. It is also a bodysuit. Just wear a new bra with it that's seamless and you should be good to go. I like that it has this kind of drop drapey neckline. You could definitely dress this up with some dress pants or wear like a cute tight skirt. So this, I don't know, I bought this actually quite a long time ago. It's called the Crepe Wrap Over Eyelet Detail Top. I think it would be very cute for the fall, and I do have something that would match perfectly with this in the Forever 21 part of my haul. Moving forward, I also have this black silky top. Now I have a white top also that kind of looks alike, but they're actually not the same thing. This I wore to dinner with the girls, and I just love how billowy the sleeves are. It's perfect for the fall and like nighttime. Deep plunging neckline, so you do have to wear like something underneath. And this is the top that looks kind of similar to it, but as you can tell, there are some differences. It is see-through, so wear a gel adhesive bra or anything. I also got this really cute knitted bodysuit that's a double bow tie. You tie it yourself and you adjust it. It looks like it could give you a super atomic wedgie in the back, but it doesn't because it's a knit material, and so cute, so comfortable. And then you can just like wear this with anything. It's so versatile. And this is lingerie, but this is what I was talking about. Like you could add underneath anything that's like a deep plunge, this bodysuit, and then it'll add like an extra component to it, just a little detail to like spruce things up. So I got two of the same skirts, and then kind of like three of this kind of same skirts. So I'll show you these three first. This was in my lookbook, and I got it in this dusty pink color, and I wore this suede material, very very soft and comfortable. You can actually literally zip it completely down or up, so you can adjust this skirt to however you want to adjust it. I love how form-fitting these skirts are. They're definitely true to size. I got them all in a size 2. And the only thing I would say is for these two skirts, when you're walking around all day in them, they start to like wrinkle right here because of the way that the cut is. kind of annoying, so I do want to warn you guys about that. Super high-waisted. You could wear a cute crop top with it, or like a bralette, like one of those structured bralettes, or like a crop top like I did in my lookbook, and it would be really, really cute. I threw it in the wash, and then it came out missing a button, so don't do what I did. It does come with extra buttons, so it's an easy fix for me. Capelets. For so long, I was like, I don't want to look like a superhero or like a vampire or anything, but they definitely grew on me this year. So cute. And it comes in a lot of other colors, but I decided on just getting this black one, and then I'll show you in a bit this white long one. But it comes in a lot of colors. It's really good quality. There is a little bit of a shoulder pad here to give it a more structured look. And yeah, it's basically like a little black superhero. Okay. And yeah, it's just super high quality. It comes in like so many other colors, but I just feel like I just need black and white, or like maybe a gray, maybe. I wore this recently going out, and it was just like a casual night, so I love like something that's like kind of thick for one of those chilly nights. It has a little American flag here. You could even wear it, like I could literally swap this jean jacket out for this, because yeah, it's like kind of giving me the same casual vibe. Here we go, the first is this baby blue off shoulder, like super off shoulder. Like it can't be a sweater dress, but it is like one of those billowy sweaters you could wear with leggings or something like that. This is not itchy also, so comfy. I love wearing this with like high-waisted maxi skirts or anything high-waisted, obviously, because I'm not gonna walk around wearing like a crop top, because honey, I love food. You can tell that I kind of work out, but I also don't say no to that slice of pizza. Moving forward, I have this jacket that is good for the fall. It's soft and it's got this lapel, and there's actually also working pockets, okay, and padded shoulders. I got it in US size 4, and this actually fits very, very, very nicely. And yeah, just very comfortable stuff. And then last but not least, I have this burgundy legging that I got on sale, size US 4. I should have gotten a 2 or a 0 even. It's like a very breathable fabric, and I don't have enough ass to fill these. So that is it for this part of the haul. Make sure to check out the other parts, and yeah, chat with me on all my social media, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!